Bushy Bay is one of many Carolina bays populating the terraces of the Cape Fear River Valley in Bladen County, North Carolina. Although the bay has a major axis of 910 meters, it is relatively small compared to the adjacent bays. Every bay is unique and deserves to be studied in order to understand the physical forces and geological mechanisms that created the bays. Bushy Bay should not be confused with the much larger Bushy Lake Bay, which is located 10 kilometers to the north. Welcome to another edition of the Carolina Bay of the Day, where we study the secondary impacts made by the glacier-ice boulders that were ejected by an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet. The names of the Carolina Bays are sometimes quirky and of unknown origin, but they are formally adopted by the U.S. Geological Survey as the names of the landforms. A satellite image of Bushy Bay shows two ditches that drain the bay through a cut in the western rim. The bay has been converted from a wetland area to a tree plantation. At higher magnification, we can see that there are dirt roads adjacent to the drainage ditches in the middle of a densely forested area. A LiDAR image of Bushy Bay shows clearly defined raised rims with a thickened portion on the southeast end of the bay. The drainage ditches can also be seen in the LiDAR image. The description of this video below has a link to the LiDAR image visualization tool and of the Carolina Bay of the Day by Michael Davias. The elliptical geometry of the bay indicates that Bushy Bay originated as an inclined conical cavity because ellipses are conic sections. The raised rims of the Carolina Bays are created from the overturned flaps of the penetration funnels, and the thick rim on the southeast is made from the material that is pushed forward by the plowing action of the projectile as it makes the cavity. The thickened rims in the leading edge of the penetration funnels are also observed in experimental impacts. Bushy Bay has some very big neighbors, and this makes it possible to compare their geometries. Horseshoe Lake Bay is a well-known Carolina Bay on the terrace of the Cape Fear River, 32 kilometers southeast of Fayetteville, North Carolina. The name is derived from the shape of the open water lake seen within the gentle depression. The remainder of the basin floor is densely forested. Horseshoe Lake is also called Shug's Mill Pond. In 1998, the state of North Carolina purchased approximately 8,000 acres of the Horseshoe Lake natural area. The tract is now managed by the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission as the Bladen County Game Land and is open to the public for hiking, fishing, boating, birding, and special permit hunting. From the LiDAR images of Bushy Bay and Horseshoe Lake Bay, it is evident that Bushy Bay has a rounder shape than Horseshoe Lake Bay. The increase in ellipticity as a function of length of the bays was described by Professors Melton and Shriver in a 1933 publication. The LiDAR image shows that Horseshoe Lake Bay overlays a smaller bay to the west, and its northwest rim is overlaid by another bay called Marshy Bay. These superpositions indicate the sequence in which the bays were emplaced. Horseshoe Lake Bay can be fitted with an ellipse with a width of 2,592 meters and a length of 4,440 meters. The width-to-length ratio is 0.58, and it corresponds to an impact angle of 35.7 degrees. Bushy Bay has a width of 650 meters and a length of 910 meters. Even though it looks small, it is almost 1 kilometer long. The width-to-length ratio of Bushy Bay is 0.71, which corresponds to an impact angle of 45.6 degrees. During re-entry through the atmosphere, a large projectile is harder to slow down by atmospheric friction than a smaller projectile with a similar initial trajectory. For this reason, the smaller projectile strikes the ground at a more vertical angle of impact, thus creating a more circular crater. These angles can be used in ballistic equations to determine the launch speed and the trajectories of the ice boulders that made the bays. Mathematically, only 5 points are needed to fit an ellipse. In the case of Horseshoe Lake Bay, we notice that the northeast rim conforms very precisely to the elliptical shape, but a portion of the rim on the west side is outside the boundary of the ellipse. Why is that? If we pay close attention, we notice that Horseshoe Lake Bay overlaps a smaller, previously emplaced bay. We can attribute the distortion of Horseshoe Lake Bay to the flow of rim material into the smaller bay. Overlapping bays often have evidence of such surface flows into previously emplaced bays. In 2006, the book by Richard Firestone, Alan West, and Simon Warwick Smith introduced the Younger Dryas impact hypothesis and brought attention to the Marshy Bay and a cluster of bays in North Carolina with overlapping rims, including Horseshoe Lake Bay. The book says, "Notice the fish scale effects at the arrows, where a top bay overlaps its middle one, which overlaps a lower one. Of the 11 bays, 10 overlap others or are overlapped. Wind or water cannot create this effect. A LiDAR image of the area described in Firestone's book shows that Bushy Bay is near this very interesting area of overlapping bays. Indeed, the fact that Marshy Bay overlaps bays in so many directions is evidence that the Carolina Bays could not have been created by the action of the prevailing wind. The best explanation for the overlaps is that they result from the impacts of multiple objects. We can learn a lot by studying the Carolina Bays one bay at a time. 99 LiDAR based on the ground, 98 based on the ground. If I make a video of one of the bays, there will be 98 based on the ground. 99 LiDAR based on the ground, 98 based on the ground. If I make a video of one of the bays, there will be 98 based on the ground. 99 LiDAR based on the ground, 98 based on the ground. If I make a video of one of the bays, there will be 98 based on the ground. 99 LiDAR based on the ground, 98 based on the ground. If I make a video of one of the bays, there will be 98 based on the ground.